we don't want to stir it, but you know, get a picture of it at least.
Now, what do you think this means?
So you took this to Washington, D.C.? And
yes, we did.
And it went where?
And we had good response, a lot of thumbs up, a lot of people were curious, and a lot of families wanted to have... Oh, Jesus. Wanted to have their pictures taken with the sign. I thought that was pretty interesting. And we wanted to do... We really wanted to do a... get out of here. A video would be good. To have a video camera and be able to capture people's reactions to it.
Very good.
So you just went?
So we decided we were going to go to the White House and protest. You know, see if anybody was protesting or what the reactions, you know, were going to be of what's going on. And so she went and talked to David Siskin. He had the sign already painted. And I thought it was a little bit strong. You know, will kill for oil. I thought, wow, that, we could be shot.
That's real subtle.
We could be, we could easily be killed. Yeah. Or at least thumped and you know.
They probably have your picture. I bet your picture's up on the wall.
That's what Roger
CIA
said.
Office.
Hope you had fun, because you'd be tailed for about 10 years now.
Yeah, there he is. Obi and Bobby. Use your undercover name is Obi. Obi and Bobby.
So and so Bobby, you know, she got the sign, we're going, we're doing it, this is what we're gonna do. She got all excited.
So what you know,
a little bit strong. A little bit much. But the night before I realized where would that be? What is the best place for that sign on the White House gates? That's exactly what it's called. And that's why, you know, we went. We were not there for very long. There was a woman that's been there since 1981 in a little plastic encampment. They won't even let her sleep at night. She has to sleep sitting up. She's been there since 81 as an anti-nuclear activist. And she's about 4 feet tall. She had this big wig on.
Oh, yeah?
That she used to keep her head warm.
Yeah.
And the next day it was going to be 35 degrees.
I bought this,
you know, high at 35. And she's there every single day. So us being there for, you know, a couple hours or something.
Go through that.
Nothing was, it was almost, you know, I wanted to go back. 350 million people live in our country. There may be 8 or 10 out there at the White House. With something to say, and I think we need to stand up for more.
So that's great that David made that.
He did.
That's a really nice one.
I can see him and Jeb sitting around the, you know, the shop over there saying, how about we kill for oil? And it put a question mark there. You know, is that true? Maybe.
Well, they had different.
Who are we? What are we doing?
This is the original free diet.
So yeah, it was a good thought provoking one.
No, that he was always
that.
What do you have to say?
About
anything.
It's a beautiful day today, and the farmer's market is so sunny and warm.
No. I want, like, real things. Like, the depth of your life and being and the world and stuff.
Oh, once you grow up, you realize there's really nothing to do except for eat and shop. Stop there.
Eat and shop stuff to do.
So how are you dealing with that?
I need a hobby of some sort. Some people have hobbies.
What kind of
hobby? Busy.
Like what kind of hobby?
I don't know.
Are you
like arts and crafts hobbies seem so dorky.
But what
I'll
you,
come up with something.
No, what have you thought about? I mean, in the back recesses of your mind, what's popped up?
I think I'd like to make photo collections.
Of what?
Like the other day I was looking at trees in the fall, and like there was yellow ones and orange ones and green ones, and I thought it would be neat to make like a little montage of them. but that would only work for like 3 weeks. I want a hobby that lasts like a whole lifetime.
So what, do you have any patterns? I mean, like other people that have hobbies that you like, that you would, that are serving for your pattern for what you're looking for?
Not exactly. You know, like I was thinking about my grandmother's, one crocheted and one sewed, and so that seemed to fill up their time, even though they didn't even work. And it was like they had stuff to do, and my aunts and uncles lived on farms, so they always had chores. I don't have chores. There has to be something to do now that you're a grown up besides eat and spend money.
I am fried chicken for breakfast this morning. Where are they?
I guess I have to have some kids, maybe. They take up a lot of time.
No, that would keep you busy.
Yeah.
Your own or adopted? Or?
Well, either one would be fine, I guess. I haven't really got that far.
That would do it.
Yeah.
That would do it.
That would definitely take up a big time chunk.
But it's kind of not something that you'd like to go into out of boredom.
No. And not because you don't want to spend money.
Right. You got no problem.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, do it. Good luck.
Thanks.
Some yams sound kind of good.
Nice hat.
You buy some yams?
Yeah, I bought some yams.
Can I try and fit them for you?
I like them.
Okay. Hold my bread.
This song I wrote a little while ago is called Wild Geese Fly, and I wrote it when I was sitting on my porch and I heard geese fly over my head. Have you guys heard that before, you know, the sound? Raise your hand if you've heard that sound. And I looked up and I saw these geese and I thought, you know, they've got something going. I mean, they're going somewhere. Unlike me, sitting on my porch, so I wrote this song. It's called Wild Geese Fly. Overhead, wild geese fly. To their home, now their winter subsided. High above, their song rings free. Long way ahead, doesn't seem hindering. What do they see? How can they tell if they're closer to home or just a few feet overhead? Do they fight about which way they should go or who should be the one leading their home? What do they do with some of the sky? Do they follow their heart with their eyes? What would I do with some of the sky? Would I follow my heart and look with my eyes? Fly. Don't
ugly gets the best of me. You know I love this old town, but don't break my heart, I'd like to stick around. This town ain't big enough for me and the heartbreak. This town ain't big enough for me and the heartbreak. Then walk away. All these women slay. You gotta track and pray to catch a small town boy. You gotta bait a cage. Call me old fashioned in an old passionate dream, but I think it's a man's place to choose his queen. This town ain't big enough for me and the heartbreak. This town ain't big enough for me and the heartbreak. You're not walking my door. You're not walking my door. You're not walking my door. Walk away. There's plenty of women that can't hold a fickle man, but my heart's not strong enough to be one of them. I need big love, strong and true, and the simple things that this small town brings. This town ain't big enough for me and the heartbreak. This town ain't big enough for me and the heartbreak. You're not walking my door. You're not walking my door. You're not walking my door. Then walk away.
Mom lets us drink mint juleps too, so good.
Yeah, Daddy's got the fiddle, all my sisters are singing on the sink.
Yeah, they let us wear our boots even on Sunday. We need to clap around on the porch too. It's really fun.
Alright, so this next song is, it's about a big bearded man and big bone Betty Sue and beans. But in fact, it's really about wanting really simple things in life that just don't turn out to be quite as simple as you think.
Alright,
I'm ready.
Oh, yeah. Alright.
Oh, we got to take off.
I was trying to open this thing.
And scale to the ground. I just want to rattle in Jennings. Well, I heard Britney Spears always Faith killer name. Well, I know she's the one on that Vogue magazine. She looks like Betty Sue when she was the county fair queen. Give me a country song and a big black dog and a big beard in my hand to warm my bed. Well, I once had me a pretty man, he loved his TV, and I traded him for my country man who loved my brown sugar baked beans and the red and red planets. But my big bearded man, I saw with big bone Betty Sue. He was only coming round for my papas every Tuesdays or two. You know where Beans took first prize this year. So give me a thunder song and a big black dog and a big bearded man to warm my bed. It's that really popular movie. Go to sleep, you little baby. Go to sleep, you little baby. Your daddy's gone away, but your mama's gonna stay. Don't need no nothing but the baby. Go to sleep, you little baby. Go to sleep, you little baby. Everybody's gone to the cotton and the phone. Don't need no mother but the baby. You're asleep, pretty baby. You're asleep, pretty baby. Honey's in the rock and the sugar don't stop. Gonna bring a bottle to the baby.
Yeah. Yeah.